This is Doc Coyle from God Forbid, and you're getting your metal fix on Metal Injection.
Rob here at the New England Metal and Hardcore Festival with one Doc from a little band called God Forbid. I say that sarcastically because you guys aren't that little. I mean, you're blowing up.
I still think we're a little band as far as
okay.
I know.
So you guys just put out Earth's Blood now, and then like right after, immediately, drama, your brother with the band.
Yeah.
Now, I mean, I know this must be like the most awkward thing to talk about in interviews, like just a little beef, but can we talk about it?
We can like, talk about it a little bit. Doesn't mean I'm going to tell you that much.
Yeah, no, I'm sure you're not going to tell me the juicy details because, you know, we're not TMZ anyway. We don't really care.
That's right.
That deep, but like, well, you know, what kind of happened? Like, what was the...
Got into a stupid argument over really something really meaningless, and he quit the day we were supposed to leave for this tour. So it is what it is. You know, it was upsetting, it was hurtful, but it also happened at the time that we're doing probably the best tour we've ever done. You know, I mean, we're playing in front of 3,000-4,000 people a night. We only had a few days to figure out what we were gonna do. You know, we got on the horn, started calling people, and, you know, tried to pick up, you know, like things never change. You know, I mean, obviously, Dallas is a massive presence, you know, with the vocals and on stage and just, you know, part of the identity of the band, you know, so it's definitely, I think, difficult maybe from a fan's perspective or even for us. But frankly, you know, if he wasn't happy, then I have no problem with him. I'd rather him be happy than be in the band.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
You guys didn't like split up as brothers, right? You're still...
I mean, it's a little rocky, you know, it's a little rocky. That's a, you know, again, I'd rather not get into it.
Okay, no, fair enough. But how is Chris been subbing in, you know, like last minute?
Chris is, I mean, as far as guitar players, you can pick up in a couple days, he's about as good as it gets. I mean, he's trained, he's, you know, he's musically, you know, incredible. You know, me and him have a very, you know, similar kind of philosophy behind some of our playing and stuff, you know, even though I think he's a bit more accomplished and technically proficient than I am, he can do things that I can't do yet, you know, but it's great, man. It's honestly, he picks up things really well, and, you know, I show him stuff and he's like, things have been about as seamless as they could have been.
Right. Is he going to be like a permanent member? Are you guys going to be looking for someone? What are you guys going to do?
I can't answer that question right now. Honestly, we're right now it's just this tour, and we got about a month between our next tour, and between now and then we'll figure that out.
Nice. And I mean, like, you guys are on probably like the biggest tour of the spring, I would say.
Yeah.
Like every band is just like a killer band, and I'm sure like the fans you guys get must be crazy. Like I even noticed today, like yesterday it was just like mostly like scene kids, kind of like people that know the music, but like today I see kids with like Ozfest shirts on, like people that normally wouldn't like check out this music. Do you find yourself playing to people that you haven't really played to before?
Well, we're in that kind of unique position of being established but not exactly being a massive band, so we go out there and people are familiar, but maybe for every one person who's familiar, there's one or two that isn't, or maybe they've heard our name but haven't heard the music. And you gotta remember too, a lot of young kids, a lot of 14, 15-year-old, 16-year-old kids who maybe just know Lamb of God.
Right.
Or they just know As They Lay Dying. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And for us, it's really like between those three bands, Lamb of God, Bodom, As They Lay Dying, we kind of get the trifecta because we kind of can kind of grab a little bit. We do,
right.
You know what I'm saying? We got some guitar stuff going on. We got some really heavy stuff going on, you know, so it's you know, and obviously, you know, we have some melody with the vocals, some, you know, we're a diverse band, and it really couldn't have gotten any better for us. And it's like, to me, the whole thing is about new fans.
Right.
I want to get out. I feel like, in a sense, we've kind of gone off the radar in the last couple years. I mean, music industry is fickle, man. It's like,
yeah.
it's like that Eddie Murphy joke. He said, "What have you done for me lately?"
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I used to be doing ISS, but what have you done lately? You know?
Yeah.
That's what people want to, you know, and that's the thing is, if you're not current and playing with new and exciting bands, then people kind of tend to put you in the back of their brains. Even
yeah,
if they
like,
are.
Oh, like whatever happened to that band kind of thing. Yeah.
So for me, it's just like almost kind of we're reintroducing ourselves again.
Yeah.
It's something you have to do being, I'd say, a veteran band. Like you can't just rely on the old fans. because that's going to, you know, and we're lucky. We have some really diehard fans, but can't rely on that. You have to constantly reach out to new people, and these opportunities for the survival and the for the band to flourish in the future and have a future, it's essential.
Yeah, and I mean, you guys have a huge gig coming up on Mayhem Fest.
Yeah.
Playing with Slayer and Manson, too. I'm sure Manson will draw kids that never even heard the name, God forbid. So it should be like this whole 6 months is just like exposing you guys to new people. Are you guys going to be like millionaires in the fall?
It'd be nice. I mean, I think for me, it's all about getting to the next level. But you can't necessarily think three moves down the road.
Right.
You have to say, all right, let's just get from A to B. And we get B, go from B to C. And we kind of, when we did like Gone Forever, we kind of got to a certain level, and we kind of, the perception kind of got a little bit bigger after that, but we kind of leveled off. And
right.
The question is, can we get to that next level?
Yeah.
You know, I mean, even if we stay at that level, we're still a pretty successful band.
Yeah, I mean, people would kill to have like what you guys have.
So I wouldn't be like upset, you know.
Yeah.
To me, this whole kind of era is about establishing us as a career band.
Right.
And by a career band, I just mean like a band that's not susceptible to trends. You know, like some bands are just like bulletproof. Like Hatebreed is bulletproof.
Yeah.
It doesn't mean, oh, Deathcore is big. Who cares? It's Hatebreed.
You know,
Clutch. You know, they don't know what trendy thing is going on. And the thing is, on our last album, Constitution, everyone was trying to kind of like, almost, it's weird, like the press decides who they get sick of in the industry. Like, oh yeah, we're sick of that style, you know? And you kind of go, oh really? You liked us before.
Yeah.
And then you realize that that's just the way things go.
Yeah,
you have to weather the storm. And that's what this is about. It's kind of like, if we can be relatively successful with this new album in a whole new scene with all these new bands, then it's going to just put the band in a different light. And then people are gonna say, okay. I guess they weren't just another band that came along with
group. Yeah, I was just talking about this to somebody else like recently, like how like 4 or 5 years ago, like metalcore was like huge. And like, honestly, I thought it was like you guys, Killswitch, and Lamb of God were like, in my opinion, like the biggest bands in metal. And then like that kind of like died out, and like after that, like every band sounded the same. Like every band sounded metalcore. And then now it's kind of like every band has that like deathcore kind of thing. And like metalcore is kind of passe sort of, but like you guys kind of moved past the metalcore. You guys are just metal.
Yeah, well, I mean, we never really saw ourselves.
Right, I mean, I guess there's just like the scene at the time and the bands coming up.
Yeah, I mean, but the thing is though, it's also the idea of being a leader and a follower.
Right.
We're one of the bands that helped influence a scene that became a metalcore scene.
Right.
But by the time that happened, we already didn't feel...
You were over it.
We just didn't... Yeah, we didn't feel anything in common with that. Like, I just found there was too much gimmickry and just stale ideas. And it was a lot of pandering. Songs weren't written for the sake of the song. It was written to invoke some type of reaction from a crowd.
Right.
Which is, to me is very shallow way of writing material. I mean, obviously you want people to like your music, but it's such a thinly veiled, short-term return on that investment.
Yeah. Right.
And even personally, I mean, I felt like we kind of maybe bended to some of those conventions out of not necessarily trying to appeal to like a certain audience, but just to maintain our own audience.
Right.
So people don't think we're going soft or we're not heavy band. But you know, but this new album was the first album that I was just like, I just didn't care. I was like, write the songs that I want to hear, you know, and go and take the song where I felt the song should go, not just because it won't have a circle pit, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You know, or whatever, you know, and it's just a different frame of mind, you know?
Yeah. Well, what I like about you, man, is like, you're always honest no matter what. You speak your mind and you don't give a fuck.
I'm not always honest. You should see what I say about you when you're not around.
Oh, fuck. Well then, fuck this guy then. Let's get out of here. But check out Earth's Blood, because it's a killer record. Go see God Forbid on the road forever.
That's right. Deluxe Jeans, baby. You know what I'm saying? Represent. www.dluxnyc.com. That's right. I pimp shit, too.
All right. Fair enough.